Good evening. Welcome to our midweek communion and Bible study. Let me read you a scripture from Luke 11 and verse 1. It says, "Now it came to pass, as he, Jesus, was praying in a certain place, when he had finished, that one of his disciples said to him, 'Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples.'" Before we continue, let's spend some time in worship.
Spirit sound, rushing wind, fire of God fall within. Holy Ghost, breathe on us, we pray. As we repent, turn from sin, revival embers smoldering. Breath of God, fan us into we need a fresh wind, the fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out.
Such a privilege to be in your home tonight. And for our Bible study, we're looking at the subject of prayer. And we see here in verse 1 that the disciples actually came to Jesus during his prayer time, during his quiet time with the Father, and they asked him to teach them to pray. So obviously they'd seen something significant and powerful in the life of Jesus that inspired them to ask Jesus to teach them. So let's read on here in verse 13, and I want to give you kind of the end of the story so we see where Jesus was going with this particular teaching on prayer. He says, "If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more," notice, "how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" Notice that Jesus culminates his training and teaching of the disciples in this moment about prayer by telling them the key to success in prayer is receiving the Holy Spirit, and that if you ask the Father for the Holy Spirit, he will give it to you abundantly. So we see tonight that if we want to be effective and powerful in prayer, we're going to need the help of the Holy Spirit. The amazing thing is we have now received the Holy Spirit because Jesus has been raised from the dead and he sent the Holy Spirit to live and dwell in us. He was also teaching them that if the Father gives you the biggest, the best, and the most precious gift, which is a piece of himself, a part of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit, why wouldn't he give you everything else you need in your life? So this builds our confidence and our faith. Let's look at the other verses and see what we can take from this teaching by Jesus. In verse 11, he clarifies what he's talking about here, and he says, "If a son asks for bread from any father among you, will he give him a stone? If he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish? Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion?" Obviously, the answer is no. And then he finishes in verse 13 and he says, "Well, if you're evil and you know how to give good things to your children, how much more won't your Father give you the Holy Spirit?" So let's go back now and let's have a look at verses 9 and see what he was teaching regarding prayer. In verse 9 he says, "So therefore I say to you, ask and it will be given to you, seek and you will find, knock and it will be opened to you." Now he's saying this in verse 9 on the back of talking about and sharing with them one of the other keys to successful prayer is perseverance. The ability to stay at it and stay with it. And so he uses these three words to inspire them and challenge them to realize that being successful in prayer is not an instant thing. You're going to need perseverance. You're going to need to lean in and press in. An important key to prayer is realizing the need to ask. And that's the first thing he says here in verse 9. He says, "Ask and it will be given to you." Sometimes there's nothing more difficult than actually asking. Because when you ask for something, it's an acknowledgement that you need help. But it's also a very important posture of humility. But there's something truly powerful. The answer to every prayer has already been given to us. How do we know that? Because verse 13, he says, "How much more will the Father not give you the Holy Spirit?" So what is this telling us here? It's telling us that the Holy Spirit is the one who makes everything that Jesus accomplished real in our lives. And when the things of God become real in your heart, you can exercise your faith for them and begin to experience them. So he is the one, the Holy Spirit, who will guide you, help you, and empower you to pray accurately and effectively. When we start to pray and not have a specific result in the natural in mind, but we're simply asking out of the deep desire and even sometimes the desperation in a good sense to experience God's provision, the Holy Spirit will always step in and assist us. I'm reminded of Romans 8, verse 26 to 28, We're not going to read it tonight, but you can go read it in your own time. It speaks about literally that the Holy Spirit is the one who helps us to pray. And that when we allow the Holy Spirit to help us in our weakness, He will make all things work together for His good. Let's look at this word ask. In the Greek, the word ask here literally means to beg, to call for, to crave, desire, or to require. It comes from the root word punathamohai, and it actually means to question or ascertain by inquiry. In other words, the first step into effective prayer is actually inquiring of God. It's getting information. It's asking for understanding. And so that's where the Holy Spirit comes in. Often we just run off and we pray prayers. Sometimes we should just be still and ask and cultivate that desire to gather information. Number two, this word in the Greek means to request of someone as a favor. And we know that because Christ is in our lives, we are highly favored. Number three, this word means to strictly command or demand something that is due. Now, it's not that we have this fleshly posture of, I demand God to answer my prayer. No, it's an attitude of respect, but it's an attitude of determination. It's an attitude of not so much demanding of God, but letting the enemy know that you will not let go of what it is you're trusting God for. It's a posture of strength. Number four, this word ask implies to search for something that is not yet revealed. In other words, it involves the idea of urgency. You see, sometimes we lack that urgency in our prayers. And because we lack that urgency and that determination, we don't go after it with all our hearts. And then number five, this word in the Greek means a call of intelligence so as to understand. In other words, prayer is not just about getting an answer of a specific thing, but it's about gaining understanding about the thing you're going to ask for, because very often you'll have your answer. Look at Luke 11 verse 10. It goes on and he says, for everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. God is on your side. God wants to lead you and guide you into a deeper relationship of prayer. And you can experience it. When we learn to pray correctly and accurately, we will receive answers. You know what I've realized? Based on this teaching in this area of prayer, many of us have already received the answer to our prayers. We just haven't recognized that the Lord has been speaking to us all the time. So today, as we partake in communion of the body and the blood of Christ, it is a celebration of what Christ has already accomplished. We go with this attitude of worthiness and respect because of the righteousness that we have in Christ Jesus. And so think about this as we partake of the bread. In Galatians 5:16, it says, I say then, walk in the Spirit and you will not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. It's because of Christ that we can walk in the Spirit. Let's partake of His body. And now as we partake of the wine, which is symbolic of the blood of Christ, which is the ratification of our redemption and the sign of the covenant. Galatians 5:16 in the Passion Translation says this, let me emphasize this, as you yield to the dynamic life and power of the Holy Spirit, you will abandon the cravings of your self-life. You are blessed by God. You have the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. And nothing can stop you from pursuing God with all your heart, the blood of Jesus Christ. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for the presence of your Holy Spirit in our lives. And I pray for every person that is listening and watching to this today. May they receive the abundance of your grace, the answers to their prayers, and a refreshing in the Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're looking forward to you being in the service on Sunday. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're so looking forward to seeing you on Sunday, either live or online, as we share in the Word together. Remember, you can go to rfcfc.com if you want to find out anything about our church times, or even download one of our teachings. God bless you. Enjoy the rest of your week, and we'll see you on Sunday.